look at how ready you all are for comedy. This is awesome. Give yourselves a big round of applause for being here, or confetti anyway. Yeah.
Well, like you said, my name is Wyatt Burp. I am your host with the most from coast to coast. Now I can say that because I actually went somewhere. You guys ready for a cool show tonight? Yes,
sir. Woo-hoo. Yeah.
Do I need to do the Hulk Hogan? Hang on. Yeah. Yeah. There we go. Yeah. All right. Let's go. So let's start off like we always do. We're going to start off with a musical number by none other than the musically super talented JoJo Noto.
Can you hear it?
Yep.
When the night has come and the land is dark and the moon is the only light we see, I won't be afraid. No, I won't be afraid. Just as long as you stand by me. So darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand now. Stand by me, stand by me. If the sky that we look upon should tumble and fall, or the mountains should tumble to the sea, I won't cry, no, I won't shed a tear. Just as long as you stand by me. And darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Honey, stop. Oh, stand now. Stand by me. Stand by me. Can you guys hear my husband? Oh, my God. Nope, they sure can't. I spoke stupid. Thanks.
Oh, I can hear him.
There he is. He's a good singer too. I can't move around because my hand is holding my phone. And darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand now. Stand by me. Stand by me. Oh, stand now. Stand by me. Stand by me.
Yeah. Yes.
Thank you. And sorry about. Yeah.
No. My husband. That was amazing. Do a duet. You should. That was so funny. That was awesome. That was amazing.
Yeah.
I realized when I was up there, I was dancing. I like looked at my suit and I was like, God, I kind of look like a California raisin. I don't know if you guys remember the California Raisins.
Oh, yeah.
I was like,
yeah.
Man, I'm like. all I need is the sunglasses, man. I got it made. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to introduce Oculos 410. Yay! Come on up, buddy. Woo! Come on. Oh, yep, that's you.
Yes.
Pointing right at you. Right at you. Here he comes. Here he comes. You're VIP. You're VIP, buddy. You don't need to hit the button.
Oh, let me see if I can catch it. Let me see if I can catch it.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes.
Finally.
I think that's the first time in the history of the Soapstone someone got the microphone catch. All right, y'all. Let's give it up for y'all, first of all. Appreciate y'all coming out. Let's see some controllers slapping together out there. Watch out, because the warranty claims are very slow these days, so slap them very gently. Slap them gently. Thanks to Wyatt Burp for hosting California Raisins. That's a throwback. I remember that back before I was born, so appreciate that, yes, that reference.
Yep.
All right, so of course, this is awkward. I didn't know I was going to be performing tonight, so hopefully I can say a couple of things, and when I pause, y'all laugh. I trust that Jay's going to edit all of the laughing track that just happened into everything I say, so I appreciate Jay's editing. Oh, we got some laugh track upstairs. I appreciate it. So it's great being here. Anybody out in the crowd like yard sailing? I'm a big fan of yard sailing. Anybody else out there like yard sailing? That's right. That's right. So I want to tell you all about this story. The other day I was out looking for some good yard sales now that it's starting to get nice out, and I drive through my neighborhood and I see this whole rack of stuff down the driveway of my neighbor's house. And I think the best part about yard sales is be able to see what all your neighbors is throwing out, you know, because all the stuff they're throwing out, usually it's like really weird stuff. They got like these strange dolls that stare at you as you're walking around, feel like they're judging me. Like if I don't pick the right stuff out of their garage, it's going to go back into their garage and it's going to live there forever. So I'm like, all right. But anyway, I got the homeowner. He's peeking around the corner at me, and I never met this guy, and he's looking all creepy. And he's like, hey, come here. Come on over. Come on by. I was like, okay, fine, fine. Let's go in here. So I go into his garage and he's like, hey, man, what are you looking for? I was like, I don't know. I'm just looking at whatever you got in here. Some nice stuff. He goes, all right, let me show you something. I got something you're going to love. Okay, I walk over to the table and he goes, this radio right here. I'm like, okay, yeah. He's like, you ever seen a radio? I'm like, yeah, I'm familiar with a radio. He goes, this is the one on you right here. He said, but there's one problem. He goes, the volume's broken on it. I'm like, you know what? I can't turn that down. Nope, there we go. A couple of y'all are following along. I appreciate it. You know, every morning when I get up and get out of bed, I get ready for work, and every time I walk out that front door, just wham, I just get smashed into by this motorcycle. Every morning I'm like, what the heck is going on? And so I wake up this morning and I figure today is going to be different, and then boom, another one. And I'm like, man, what a vicious cycle, you know. All right. See, I appreciate the house track because it makes me sound funnier, and if you know, self-esteem and all that. But anyway, so I has anybody in here been to VR chat? I know that everybody kind of lives in Horizon, but before I came into Horizon, oh, a couple of y'all were real proud of that. That's a little weird, but I went into VR chat before I came into Horizon. I think I saw your avatar in there. Were you the hot dog with the mustard stain? Was that you? All right. I was in VR chat before I came into Horizon. I was waiting for my invite. And I was like, you know what? These videos on YouTube are hilarious. I'm going to go viral or something. You know, that's always the goal. You know, you go into VR chat, you're hoping somebody's recording. Well, not this time. I went in VR chat and all these weird like condiments and food items come running up on me. And they're like doing all kind of weird stuff to my legs. And I mean, it's good to not have legs now. That's probably the one good thing about being in Horizon, not having legs. I don't have these weird food items coming up and humping me, but so there's this like gang of food items coming at me, and I'm like, what is going on? I've been here 3 seconds and I'm already getting attacked. And there's this like Hershey bar who's like leading the gang of food items. And I'm like, whoa, bro, I don't want any problems. And this Hershey bar is like, don't assume my pronoun. And I'm like, I apologize. I should be respectful. I'm like, what's your pronoun, candy bar? And they said Hershey. And I was like, oh. All right. I don't want to waste anybody else's time. Thank you all so much. Thank you for humoring me and giving me my third time on stage. I love Horizon. I love you guys. Give it back to Wyatt Burp. Let's see if we can do the mic toss. Oh, let's see if we can do the mic toss. All right. Edit that back out. Here we go.
Here we go.
One, two, three, four.
Oh,
five. Oh, I'm doing some curls. I'm getting the curls in.
I don't know if you saw, but I...
Oh, well. We'll try next time.
Did anybody see anything?
That was amazing. Ladies and gentlemen, one more time for Oculos. He killed it. Especially with only having just a couple minutes of preparation there. Man, oh, man. Preparation H. Anyway. Preparation H is great on the whole. That's an old Austin Powers joke.
Yeah.
Hey now. Yeah. All right, guys. That was amazing. Let's keep the show moving right along. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Summer 1221. Come on up.
Summer.
All you.
Yeah.
Ready?
Yay! Thank you. It feels great to be here. My name is Summer Sparrow. I am soon to be an adjunct professor at North Carolina Central University as a multiple intelligence educator. I have a love for music, a love for children, and a love for all things that give God glory. Straight like that. Who you are is who you are. Come as you are. We are well-dressed tonight. We look good. We are fine, y'all. We are fine. We are summertime fine. Bring it, live it, love it. We are here. We are rainbow people. We are LGBTQ plus. They added the plus, y'all. Like Disney Plus, we are in there. We are in there. I can mention them. What did Dave Chappelle say? I can mention them. We are Disney Plus. We are important. We matter. We care. I care. So if you ever need Summer's help, allow me to reintroduce myself. My name is Summer Sparrow, and I am the Hood Alexa. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen.
I'll respond. I'll get to you when I can, but thank you. Bye, y'all.
Give it up for Summer. Give it up for Summer.
Summer.
Oh, my God. Man, I feel like a lot of love and light right now. That's amazing. You make everybody feel good, right? Yeah, that's amazing. All right. Well, without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, I think it's time to close out with our own world creator. What do you think? Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the unemployed alcoholic.
All right, Wyatt. Wyatt. Man, this has been such a fun, good show. I've been waiting for Summer all winter, and here she was. JoJo, man, how great was that? JoJo. Your husband even made a cameo appearance. That was cool.
Yes. Oh, girl, you go, girl.
That was cool. Tell him, just for that, we're going to double your pay.
A new one.
We're going to double your pay because of that.
Yes.
Yeah, extra confetti. And of course, Oculos, man, opening us up with a guest. That was great stuff. I got to tell you, he said, who likes garage sailing in here? And I've never seen so many hands go up. Like, you'd have thought he was like, hey. A lot of you know me, but for those of you who don't know me, I am known as the unemployed alcoholic. Yeah.
Are you
I'm actually
with the
a recovering
song?
Alcoholic. I am now 5 years sober.
Congratulations. That's a big deal, man.
Yeah, and that is with just two cheat days a week. Bunby, you look a little too happy about that. That's not really the secret recipe to success. I built a website, theunemployedalcoholic.com. That was available. Yeah. It's a good website. It's easy to remember unless you're my friend Chris. Chris called me up one day and he said, hey, what's the name of that website of yours again? TheLazyPervert.com? I said, no, that was taken. I've got a CPAP machine. Yeah, that's the machine that I plug my face into to make sure I don't forget to breathe at night. It looks a little bit like an oxygen tube, except bigger and more motivated.
Oh, yeah. It's on steroids. Yeah.
It's a little bit like scuba gear, and it's a lot like, and it sounds a lot like someone keeps opening and closing the door on a windy day.
Oh, my goodness.
It's sexy, is what I'm saying.
Is it lit up?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah. It's sexy. My wife digs it anyway. Not in a fetish kind of a way. She's never been like, put on the mask. Man, so you guys enjoying the show tonight?
Yes.
Loving it, dude. Loving it.
All right. Yeah, this is fun. This is great. I got to tell you, it's super fun to be up here with you guys hanging out. I'm married. I've been married for 27 years.
Wow.
You sure?
Yeah.
That's most of my adult life.
Yeah. That's with just two cheat days a week. Yeah, she's going to do what she's going to do, though.
Oh, my God.
She loves you, even still.
Summer's trying to do marital counseling over here. She loves you. She really does.
She does. In theory, not in spirit and truth yet.
In theory. Yeah, no, she does. And that, too, is a joke, you know, so Mac Gino don't get too amped up about that. Some of these are just jokes.
Catching me off guard with all of them.
Got him.
All right, everybody. I'm Aaron Sorrells, the unemployed alcoholic. Thank you so much for letting me share. Welcome back to the stage, your host, Wyatt Burp.
Ladies and gentlemen, we can go ahead and end this evening. You guys did a great job, everybody. Thank you so much for coming in. Feel free to hang out. It's an open room anyway, right? I can't kick you out.
All right. Quickly. Everybody say it was really easy to become the unemployed alcoholic because I was unemployed and I was battling alcoholism.
I feel alone. I am not alone.
All right. Awkward group selfies. Everybody just jump in and get all close and turn your bubbles off. Getting bullied now. I feel like I'm getting bullied in this circle. Bouncing off of everyone. All right, here we go.
Thanks for watching. Aaron Sorrells, the unemployed alcoholic here. I am glad that you are finding value in what we're doing and enjoying it. Hope to see you soon at the Soapstone Comedy Club, or you can always find me at my website, theunemployedalcoholic.com. See you soon.